Hello students, welcome to the virtual classroom. Now the tone has changed and it's English literature for 3 days. As you know, it's from Monday to Wednesday. So your next chapter 2 is the conceited python. The meaning of this topic is that the proudy python, and python means a large, heavy bodied, venomous snake. So we all love to keep pets. They can be birds, animals or reptiles. So we all love, like we all keep cats, dogs, rabbits, parrot as pet in their homes. Okay, so now, so the theme of the story is a story which we are going to read today is animals, and the characters are in the story are, I'm going to show you the characters so you can remember before reading the story. These are the characters in the story. You will find grandfather, grandmother, Aunt Mabel, and the author himself. Okay, so these are the four characters in the story. Okay, so let's start the story here. There was one pet which grandfather could not keep for very long. Grandmother was tolerant of some birds and animals, but she drew the line at reptiles. Here we can say that grandfather could not keep there was one pet which grandfather could not keep for very long. In the story it was told that there was a pet that grandfather could not keep for very long because grandmother was tolerant of some birds and animals, but she drew the lines at reptiles because grandmother did not like the reptiles. She likes the birds and animals as pets. She can keep them, but she does not like the reptiles. Even a chameleon as sweet as tempered as Henry made her blood run cold. Even a lizard, chameleon means a lizard that can change color. So she cannot keep a chameleon also because it make her afraid. Grandmother should have known that there was little chance of being allowed to keep python. So that's why grandfather was very aware that grandmother will never agree to keep a python as a pet in the house. He never could resist buying unusual pets. And while we still had Toto, Toto is a monkey. The monkey, he paid a snake charmer in the bazaar only 4 rupees for the young 4-foot python that was on display to a crowd of eager boys and girls. So in the He paid a snake charmer grandfather when he was in the market. He saw a snake charmer and he paid 4 rupees for the young 4-foot python that was on display to a crowd of eager boys and girls. Grandfather impressed the gathering by slinging the python over his shoulder. So there the grandfather did one action that he took the python over his shoulder, and it was the point of attraction. And walking home with it, and like this only he just came home. The first to see them arrive was Toto. The first one who see the grandfather like this, that python was over there on his shoulder, swinging from a branch of the jackfruit tree. He was swinging, latak raha tha on the from a branch of the jackfruit. Jackfruit is a vegetable tree that is kathal tree. One look at the python, ancient enemy of his race, because it was the ancient enemy of his race of Toto. So he fled into the house. Fled into the house means he ran to the house immediately, squealing with fright. Dar se chillate hue, the noise brought grandmother onto the veranda. So after hearing the noise, grandmother just ran to the veranda where she nearly fainted at the sight of the python. When she saw the python, she was just nearly going to be faint. Curled around grandfather's throat. When he saw that the python was curled around the grandfather's throat. Throat means gala. It will strangle you to death, she cried. Get rid of it at once. She just cried that just leave away. Leave it away. Nonsense, said grandfather. He is only a young fellow. But the grandfather replied, he is just a kid. He will soon get used to us. When he will be with us, he will soon get used to us and learn how we live. He might indeed, said grandmother, but I have no intention of getting used to him. And you know your cousin Mabel is coming to stay with us tomorrow. She will leave the minute she knows where is a snake in the house. But She said that I can be keep it, but you know that the aunt, your cousin Aunt Mabel, is coming to stay with us, and when she will see the snake in the house, she will immediately leave the house and run away. Well, perhaps we should show it to her soon as she arrives, said grandfather, who did not look forward to the visit of relative any more than I did. You will do not such thing, said grandfather. Grandfather said, when she arrives, first I will show her that this is snake. So he will not visit the relatives anymore. But grandmother denied that you will not do this thing. Well, I can't let it loose in the garden. Well, I cannot leave this python in the garden, said grandmother. It might find its way into the poultry house. It can go anywhere and hide itself. And then where would we be? Oh, how irritating you are, grumbled grandmother. Lock the thing in the bathroom, then go out and find the man you bought it from. Grandmother said, first you lock the thing in the bathroom, just go and find anything where you can keep this snake, this python, and just go back to the market and get the man from where you have brought this snake, and just go and return it to that man. And so in my awestruck presence, grandmother took the python into the bathroom and placed it in the tub. Grandfather went into the bathroom and placed that snake in the